So, Deshakala in Swapna is not Uchita, therefore it is Mithya. Now you have Deshakala, which is to be assumed to be there. Their Utpatti has to be assumed. If you assume the Utpatti of Deshakala, then Karana is what? Karana has to be Brahma for them, Ishvara. And that Karanatva Pratiti in Deshakala is by Anyata Khyati because it really belongs to Brahma. So that's one paksha we saw. The other paksha is that Brahma is not Karana at all. Why? Because Utpatti of everything is simultaneous. Brahma is not Karana because Brahma is Nirguna. And in that second paksha we are looking at, this is the Mukhya Siddhanta. परमात्मनि तु कारणता नास्ति तस्मात् कारणत्वादि धर्मशून्यस्य असंगस्य चैतन्यस्य कारणत्वं देशकालयो प्रतीयते इति उक्तिर् न संगच्छति. सो यू कैन नॉट से दैट कारणत्व प्रतीति आल्सो इज देयर इन देशकाल आकाशादि प्रपंच कारणता प्रतीति बिकॉज़ Brahma is not Karana. You cannot have Anyata Khyati transferring that Karanata from Brahma to Deshakala because Brahma is not Karana at all. Brahma does not have Karanata. Why? Shruti also says so. Apurvam anaparam anyadevatad viditad atho viditad adhi natasya karyam karanam cha vidyate karya karanata yatra kinchir upapadyate यादृगेव परम ब्रह्म तादृगेव जगत्त्रयम् इत्यादि श्रुति स्मृति शतेभ्यः. देयर आर सेवरल श्रुतिज एंड स्मृतिज विच निगेट द कारणत्व एजम्पशन ऑफ ब्रह्म अपूर्व अनपरम. इट इज नीदर द कारण नॉर द कार्य. अन्यदेव तद विदिताद अथो अविदिताद अधि. सो दिस फ्रॉम केनोपनिषद अर्लियर वाज फ्रॉम बृहत. So what does this say? Anya devatad viditat. What is vidita? What is known? That which is known to you or to someone else is known. That is karya. Anya devatad viditat. Tad brahma anyad bhavati. Kasmat viditat. Karyat anyad bhavati. Then aviditat. That which is not known but which has potential to be known. Which can be known. Sometime later by someone else. Elsewhere, whatever it is, that it can be known, right now unknown, can be unmanifest also, but that is different from that also. Adhi is in a sense of difference here. Anyad itself, in that sense, aviditad adhi. Adhi, so then Bhashya explains how it gets the meaning of adhi. Na tasya karyam karanam cha vidyate. This Brahma does not have any karya, meaning it is not a karana. कार्यकारणता ही अत्र न किंचित् उपपद्यते. सो देयर इज नो कार्यकारणता पॉसिबल इन ब्रह्म नॉट इवन अ बिट. यादृगेव परम ब्रह्म तादृगेव जगत्त्रयम्. देन व्हाट इज दिस प्रपंच? इट इज ब्रह्म. द अपीयरेंस इज मिथ्या. इट इज सद्ब्रह्म अपीयरिंग एज समथिंग एल्स. दैट अपीयरेंस इज नाम रूप वाचारंभण वाचारंभणम विकारो नाम ज्ञेयम. दैट इज मिथ्या. सो यू कैनॉट हैव कारणता इन ब्रह्म. देयर बाय श्रुतिज एंड स्मृतिज ऑल्सो से दिस व्हाट यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड यूजिंग लॉजिक ऑल्सो. देयर इज ऑफकोर्स डिपेंडेंसी ऑन श्रुति फॉर एनी लॉजिक टू बी यूज. इट शुड नॉट बी शुष्क तर्क. But without Tarka, if you say Shraddha, so there was a question yesterday, Shraddha in the Shruti. Shruti is Pramana, all right, but then how much Shraddha do we have? If Shruti says Tattvamasi, you know Tattvamasi, oh, Shruti says that I am Brahma. Is our journey over? It isn't over. It is the beginning really. How it is so, whether we understand it and whether we can hold on to it. If we don't have any doubts, well and good, Uttamadhikari. Shruti says, Tattvamasi. I understand aham brahmasmi, my journey is over. If I do not have any doubts, we cannot say that I have thousands of doubts or even a single doubt, and then they say that tarka is not useful. Tarka is useful because it can be known only in buddhi. Buddhi's role is to bring this thought to culmination. So I am particularly not of the opinion to set tarka aside, because tarka manana is tarka rupa. You cannot say it is manana siddha to me, but I am not using tarka. So you have to be a little careful not to throw the baby with the bath water. So tarka is useful. Tarka siddhanta darshana has two parts. One is logical analysis and the other is their darshana, which is philosophy. That philosophy should be set aside, but the tarka logical analysis has to be held on to. Of course, it has flaws. Every logic, everything has flaws. Even Shruti, if you try to understand and if you read multiple Shrutis, you hear multiple Shrutis, there will be apparent contradiction. That contradiction, how do you know it is apparent? It is real for people who do not have any sampradaya backing. So they cannot resolve it. They think it is contradictory. They'll set the Shruti aside. But we, having sampradaya, we have to resolve it. But how do you resolve it? Which one is to be taken? For that, Mimamsa, Tarka, all these are necessary. Vedanta is Uttara Mimamsa and Uttaratvam Kim. It builds upon others. It corrects where things have been misunderstood and uses everything else which is useful. So Shruti itself and Smriti also says that Karya Karanata is not there in Brahma. Kintu Maya Krita Anirvachaniya Desha Kalau Anirvachaniya Karanatvamantau Bhavataha. So these Desha Kalas are Anirvachaniya. They have Anirvachaniya Utpatti, which is by Maya. So Maya Krita Anirvachaniya Desha Kalau Anirvachaniya Karanatvamantau Bhavataha. What kind of karanatva do they have? They have anirvachaniya karanatva. In reality though, tattvataha paramarthatastu deshakalayoho nasti karanata svapne kaschana aputraha vandhya purusha svakiyam putram pautram cha pashyati. Example is given, svapna drishtanta is the drishtanta. Svapne kaschana aputraha vandhya purusha. So people think, you know, when we talk about Vandhya Putra is only a woman. It is not true. A man may not be able to beget children. It's a biological flaw. It is due to Prarabdha, of course, but biological flaw. It can be a man's body or woman's body is irrelevant. Vandhya Purusha is one who does not have children. That Aputraha Vandhya Purusha, Kaschana, whosoever is, Swapne. In the Swapna, what does he has desire for a child. He does not have it. He feels bad and he dreams about having a child, growing up old, them getting married, his children getting married, or his child, son getting married and begetting another child. So he has got grandson now, or grandchildren, whatever you say. So Swakiyam Putram Pautram Cha Pashyati. Whose Putra and Pautra is it? The dreamers. Where this Vekar has identification. Vekar Jiva. Sorry. So tatra putra pautrayoho shariram anirvachaniyata utpadyate. In Swapna, putra and pautra sharira has taken utpatti. How? Anirvachaniyata. Putra sharire pautra shariram prati anirvachaniya karanata cha utpadyate. Now this karanata was said to be there earlier in Chaitanya. That Chaitanya karanatva or karanata appears in Swapna Padarthas. How? By Anyatha Khyati. This was what was said in the earlier Paksha. We should not mix up Pakshas. Both these Pakshas are different. In the first case, Karanatva is assumed in Brahma. In the second case, Karanatva is not there in Brahma. Where Karanatva is there in Brahma, that appears elsewhere in Swapna Padarthas. In the Swapna Pita, there is Karanatva Bhrantihi. Why is it a Bhranti? Because the Swapna Pita and Swapna Putra Utpatti is simultaneous. So the Karanatva in चैतन्य अधिष्ठान चैतन्य अपियरिंग ओनली इन पिता बट नॉट इन पुत्र दिस वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड यूजिंग दिस एग्जाम्पल दि देश काल हैविंग कारणत्व विच इज देर इन ब्रह्म विच इज अधिष्ठान नॉट ओनली फॉर देश काल बट ऑल्सो फॉर आकाशादि प्रपंच बट आकाशादि प्रपंच डू नॉट गेट कारणत्व स्टेटस was established by using this very example that Swapna Pita has Karanatva which is there in Adhisthana Chaitanya but Swapna Putra does not have Karanatva status from same Adhisthana Chaitanya. That is the first Paksha. There, the transference of the Karanatva from Adhisthana to the Adhyastha that too selectively is a Bhranti but the transference is through appearance is a bhranti, transference is through anyata khyati, not anirvachani khyati. But in the second paksha, karanatva is not there in Brahma at all. If karanatva is not there in Brahma, then the swapna padarthas are utpanna through anyata khyati. So anyata khyati explains the utpatti of swapna padarthas, putra as well as pita as well as pautra also, but the Karanatva is not a transference. To transfer, it has to be there in the Adhisthana. Adhisthana Chaitanya does not have Karanatva at all. Then how can it be Anyata Khyati? So in this case, we have to say the Karanatva in the Pita, Swapna Pita, is by Anyata Khyati. So Utpatti of Karanatva is also through Anyata Khyati in the second Paksha where Karanatva is not accepted in Brahma. Because of being nirguna, nirgunatvat, karanatvam nasti brahmani. And this has to be extended to the exemplified deshakala. What about the deshakala having karanatva? Deshakala utpatti is anirvachanitaya and deshakalayoho karanatvam also karanatvasya utpatti api anirvachanitaya. So that is explained here. Putra sharire pautra shariram prati anirvachaniya karanata cha utpadyate. Natu swapne paramarthata putra pautrayoho shariram va putra pautra sharireyoho parasparam karana karyata va asti. There is no karya karana sambandha in swapna putra pita sambandha or putra pautra sambandha. Tatha eva deshakalau anirvachaniyau eva pratibhataha. Similarly, in the exemplified Jagratavastha, Deshakala also have Karanatva and Karyakarana Sambandha is there. Ittham Uchita Deshakala Rupa Samagri Mantarena Eva Jagrat Prapancha Utpadyate. Therefore, Jagrat Prapancha is Bhranti. Why? Because without having Deshakala, which is appropriate, that Samagri is missing. Deshakala is Samagri for Akashadi Prapancha that is missing. It is not uchita. Ataha jagradapi swapnavat mithya eva. There is a typo here. Yatha swapno upalabhya manas tri putra adinam swapne eva sukadukha hetuta bhavati natu jagradadau tadatesham abhava tatha eva jagrat padarthanam api tatkalika sukadukhadi hetutvam eva natu swapnadau sukadukhadi hetutvam. So just like the Swapna padarthas, such as stri, putra, for this purusha, stri is wife. Whether a person has a wife in swapna, he may not be married in the jagratavastha, but in swapna avastha, he has a wife, he has children, he has grandchildren. All of those can become a sukadukha hetu, where in only the dream. Swapne eva sukadukha hetu ta bhavati, natu jagratadau. The person who is Vandhya Purusha has no benefit of the Swapna Putra. Tada Tesham Abhavat. Because in Jagrat and Jagrat Adav, Adav has been mentioned. Which other place? So Shushupti, Samadhi Avastha, in those there is no Swapna Putra, Swapna Stri, Swapna Potri. Tatha eva Jagrat Padarthana api Tatkalika Sukha Dukkhadi Hetuttvam eva. Only in that moment there is utpatti of Jagrat Padartha. They are not available in other Deshakala. We have seen this earlier. Jagrat Padarthas also have Utpatti only in a particular Deshana, particular Kala. Natu Sopnado Sukadukhadi Hetutvam. Even if you say it is useful to me in Jagrat Avastha total, it is not useful in Swapna. So Swapna is Mithya from the Jagrat perspective, but Jagrat is also Mithya from Swapna perspective. You should not analyze everything sitting in Jagrat and consider that the analysis has to be from that standpoint. Of course, the analysis will be in Jagrat Avastha because you are a sadhaka in the Jagrat Avastha. Unless a person becomes a sadhaka in a Swapna Avastha, the analysis in Swapna is not possible. So, assuming that the person is sadhaka in the Jagrat Avastha, the analysis has to be done in the Jagrat Avastha. Moksha is possible in the Jagrat Avastha. But the analysis should not be only from the Jagrat Avastha standpoint. The perspective has to be swapped and analyzed, switched and analyzed. You have to analyze the Swapna Padarthas from the Jagrat Avastha, which you already do. But you have also to analyze the reality of the Jagrat Avastha from the Swapna perspective while being in the Jagrat Avastha itself. Okay, we have some bhajanas going in the background. Okay. Tada tesham padarthanam abhava. Tada swapna avasthayam swapna kale tesham jagrat padarthanam abhavat. They are sukadukhadi hetu only in jagrat avastha, not in swapna. A person who has a lot of pain, bodily pain, in Jagrat Avastha, takes a sleeping pill, sleeps happily and dreams happily. So there is no connection between Jagrat and Swapna, Sukha Dukha. Tasma Jagrat Swapna Samau Eva. Both are same, there is no difference between the two. But then there are many people who bring about questions as to how can you establish Jagrat Avastha as same as Swapna. There are so many differences. So some of these will be looked into. Some are understood in the analysis that has been done here. Those who have Shraddha, for them there is Vedanta Siddhanta Pramana is quoted. Traya Swapnas Traya Avasthaha Ayam Avastho Ayam Avastho Ayam Avasthaha. So Traya Swapnaha, all these three are Swapna. These Avasthas, all these three are not only Swapna and Jagrat also, Sushupti is also Swapna. Where? In Brahma. In Brahma they are all actually Tuchha. And this person is what? Ayam Avastaha, Jagrat Avastaha, Purushaha, Jagrat Avastaha, then Swapna Avastaha, Ayam Avastaha, then you can say Swapna Avastaha, Purushaha, Sushupti Avastaha, Purusha. So these are all three Bahuris for three Avasthas, which are Sri Linga, but this is Avastaha is a Pullinga. So it is a giveaway that it is a Bahuri. Swasvapnam aparokshena drushtva pashyan swajagaram chintayeda pramattasan ubhavunadin muhuhu. Swasvapnam aparokshena, this sakshatkara, you analyze it yourself. It should be aparoksha jnana, not that someone tells you. Each, see, if I describe my swapna, you have not had it, you cannot relate to it. But each and every jiva has swapna. You have your own swapna, you analyze your own swapna, and then having seen that, pashyan drishtva, swajagaram pashyan. Chintayet. So swapnam, swaswapnam drushtva, swajagaram pashyan, apramattasan chintayet. One should think. Because you can think on your own swapna. Your jagrat avastha anubhava, swajagara is your own anubhava. Swapna is your own anubhava. Analyze it and see how you felt in your Swapna Avastha and what you are feeling now in your Jagrat Avastha. Is the intensity of Sukha when you get a same padartha in swapna or in jagrata avastha, is the intensity same or is it different? Are all the emotions comparable for you as a dreamer and for you as a waker? Are they or are they not comparable? What is the difference? There is no difference. But you should be convinced of it. Nobody else can tell you. Therefore, aparokshena. Apramattasan. You should not be negligent of the facts as they are. You should not get a bias from someone else or something else. No, I have my parents here right now. I have my spouse, my children here right now. You had some other family or the same family, a different, a little different, same, whatever in Swapna also. So don't get biased by the waker's anubhava while analyzing the dream experience. Apramattasan, do not be negligent of the accuracy. Keep to that accuracy. And then ubhau, when should you analyze it? Both these experiences, ubhau muhuhu anudinam. Muhu is punah punah. Paunah punyena apramattasan chintayed. One should analyze. When? Anudinam. Dinam dinam anu. Dine dine ityartha. Each and every day, that is why the best time to think about, because swapnas we forget. We have a life, you know. They say that in Hindi they say, you know, roj marna ki jindagi. So every day you have to fight and live. Each and every day you have to live on. Each day is a fight. Most of us have a, you know, if it is not with something, it is something else. If it is not health, it is wealth. If it is not wealth, it is some relation. Something or the other keeps the life ticking. It drags us. When do you get time to recollect the dream? Forget all that. This is what the process is. Each and every day we want to forget everything else, but whatever is there at that point of time. So at least what we owe to ourselves as sadhakas is, as soon as we wake up, try to recollect a dream. Take a few minutes, analyze what is the dream, each and every detail. Make it a meditative process. Compare with the day that you are in, the Jagrata Avastha. Jagrata Avastha experiences are very strong. You don't forget them easily. So whatever was your experience yesterday, day before, whatever, and compare that with the Swapna experience. There's no difference. So anudinam muhuhu ubhau apramattah chintayet. Chirantayoho sarvasamyam anusandaya jagare satyatva buddhim santyajya nanurajyati purvavat. Then this person who has done this chintana, let us send in the, all of this is generally said in the third person, prathama purusha, but you have to make it uttama purusha. So tayoho swapna jagrayoho chiram sarvasamyam anusandhaya. Everything is same. Similar, samyam anusandhaya. Having understood that, where? Jagare. In jagrata avastha, having understood that, satyatva buddhim santyajya. There is a typo here. Santyajya, having given up. Samyak tyajya. Samyak, you cannot say samyak tyajya, you have to say samyak tyaktva. Santyajya is samyak tyaktva, because lyab is a replacement only when you have an upasarga other than nanj. So samyak tyaktva santyajya, what? Satyatva buddhim. Kutra swapne tu asti eva, but jagare api, jagare satyatva buddhim santyajya. So jagare anusandhaya, jagare satyatva buddhim santyajya. Esha sadakaha jnani bhutva purovat nanurajyati. Everything else has to be supplied to understand. So na anurajyati, there is no ranjarage Raga isn't there, Ramana isn't there, there is no enjoyment in the Vishaya, Jagrat Vishayas, Jagrat Padartha, Ityadi, Shruti, Smriti, Shatebhya. There are so many such in Panchadashi, in Shruti and Smriti, and other Vedanta Grantha. Jagrati Padartha, Jnana Samakalam, Yotpadyante, Ajnat Satta Bhavad, Dvitiya Jagra Paryantam, Dvitiya Jagrana Paryantam, Nanu Vartante, Jagra Swapna Padartha, Astiraha. So now, what is the Drishti Srishti Vada conclusion really? What is it really? Jagrati Padartha Jnana Samakalam Eva Utpadyante. As and when you wake up from the Shushupti Avastha, whether you have gone through Swapna or not, you wake up from Shushupti. Once you wake up, that time this Jagrata Padartha has also wake up. Utpadyante, they also come about with you. They don't have a real existence. They haven't been there all through the night when you have been sleeping. How do you know? How do you know they haven't been there? Because you have not witnessed them. Had they been there, you would have witnessed them. No, but others witnessed them. How do you know others witnessed them? Because others told me on waking up. How do you know that the others were there to witness that? They told me so. When did they tell you? When I woke up. So they also had utpatti when you woke up. How do you know that they existed when you slept? You don't know. Someone else has to tell you. If someone else tells you, then that someone else, was he there or he or she was? I mean, how do you know that they were there during your sleep? You don't know. So that is the Ajnata Satta. Ajnata Satta is that Satta that is Ajnata, meaning it is not known to you. That Satta which is not known to you, does it exist or does it not exist? Jagrat Padarthas do not have their own Satta. They do not exist when you are in Shushupti. Others that confirm that the Jagrat Padarthas were there when you are sleeping, when you were sleeping, their Satta also is Ajnata Satta. It is not known to you. Now there are two pakshas. Whether that Ajnata Satta exists or does not exist. So what is not known, does that plane of existence exist or does it not? Some say that it is there, some say it is not there. So both are acceptable in Drishti Srishti Vada also. Ajnata Satta Abhavad. Ajnata Sattayaha Abhavad. Dvitiya Jagarana Paryantam Na Anuvartante. They are not there. Unless you wake up, you do not have to consider their existence at all. Jagrat Swapna Padartha Astiraha. They are Astira. We know that they are not having Trikala Satta. They are also, therefore also Astira. But there is Astiratvam all the way. What is the Mukhya Siddhanta? Mukhya Siddhanta Ajnanam Eva Jagrat Padarthanam Stiratva Buddhihi. What is this Stiratva? This is a general question which people think cannot be answered. What is the question? When I wake up, I see that everything is as it was when I went to sleep. Whereas, if I go back to sleep and dream again, I don't have the continuity of the dream. So, stiratva of Jagrat Padarthas is because of that continuity which is there. That is stiratvam. I woke up in the same bed that I slept. I woke up in the same house that I slept in. or everything else is same. All the people around me are the same. I have the same relatives, same friends, same parents, same children, same spouse. However, in dream, there is no continuity. Why across? Within the dream also, there is no continuity. I am sitting in my childhood house. Suddenly, I find myself at workplace. From workplace, I am suddenly on a trekking trip to Himalayas. I come back from the Tirtha Kshetra. And I find some other family, something else going on. God knows what is happening in Swapna. There is no continuity. This is a waker's analysis, not the dreamer's analysis. If the dreamer's analysis had been like that, he wouldn't be dreaming, he would wake up. The dreamer does not consider that he had no father and has suddenly popped up. He thinks that this father has always been there. He does not question where did this father come from. So there is continuity even in the dream. Suddenly one finds oneself in the office working while, he was playing around somewhere in childhood. He was playing around in the childhood house. Suddenly he finds himself working in the office in the dream. But does the dreamer really question it? There is a time lapse as per the Jagrat analysis. But then the dreamer does not care for the time lapse. He may get a surprise as to what happened, but then that fades away. There are so many surprising and, unbelievable moments in Jagrat Avastha also. We just set them aside. We say, this is how it is. Why? I don't know. I don't understand everything. Similarly, the dreamer thinks, I don't understand everything. But it is so, there's a fact. I have my indriyas as pramana. I am dealing with it. I have workload to do in the office. I cannot say that, just moments back, I was playing around in my childhood house. Does not work because I have to live in the moment. I cannot run away from the moment. I cannot wish it away. This experience of the dreamer is not different from the waker's experience. Waker also wants to run away from the moment at times, but cannot run away. So this waker who says that I wake up to this continuous prapancha, day in, day out, it's the same surrounding, same world, does not feel that the dream continues. What I dreamt yesterday and what I am dreaming now or this morning when I woke up versus day before yesterday, all these dreams do not have continuity at all. But we have examples where there has been continuity also. I had mentioned this earlier. The Sringeri Acharya, earlier Acharya, had a continuous set of dreams till he learned the entire set of yoga asanas, which are not there in even Hatha Yoga Pradipika. So, Hatha Yoga. So, he learned directly from Bhagavan Shiva. There was a continuous set of dreams. Day in, day out, he lived the same dream, not same dream, continuous dream. One asana after the other, after the other, after the other, till everything was learned by him. Everything was taught by Shiva to him. So that example is that some of us have experience of dreams recurring, continuity being there or being stuck in the same dream. I used to have a dream, one particular dream once a year, but on the same day. There was some puja we used to do. On that day, even as a child, for many years, I used to have one single dream. Once a year. So naimittika, it was like naimittika. You don't know, you cannot make an assumption that there is no continuity. But then here the analysis is done in a different manner. Nanu jagarat swapnam anubhuya punar jagrane sati prathama jagare ye arthaha anubhutaha teva swapna vyavahita dvitiya jagare api anubhuyante. So dvitiya jagarana paryantam nanuvartante swapna padarthaha जागृत पदार्थ तु अनुवर्तन्ते, दिस इज द थिंकिंग। द्वितीय देर नॉट द्वितीय जागरण बट द्वितीय हियर व्हाट इज सेड, जागृति पदार्थ ज्ञान समकालम एव उत्पद्यन्ते, दिस इज सिद्धांत अज्ञात सत्ता भावाद। व्हाई दिस हेतु, बिकॉज देर इज नो सत्ता विच इज वेनी पदार्थ विच हैज अज्ञात सत्ता, दैट काइंड ऑफ पदार्थ डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट, देर इज नो अज्ञात सत्ता। Therefore, Dvitiya Jagrana Paryantam, if you have woken up once and then you wake up the next day, the second time, there is no continuity. Na anuvartante. So, the padarthas that you are seeing around, they are not the same which were there yesterday. Sorry. So, why is there no continuity? Because there are different padarthas. Ajnata satta bhavad, there is an utpatti, jnana samakalam eva utpadyante. When you woke up now, you know a ghata next to you, there is a clock next to you. You don't use clock these days, you don't use alarm clocks, most of us use mobile phones. So it's different. Why? Now simple analysis won't do. If it works, you know, jnana samakalam, that is fine. Because you saw it, there is satta to that padartha. Because you hear something, there is satta to that padartha, shabda padartha. But if you go back a little, for each and every padartha, what is the karana? There is deshakala also. If you say, I find the things in the same place, same desha that you have kept it, is it in the same desha? Yes. Is it in the same kala though? No. So kala has changed, karana has changed now. So karana changing, karya cannot be same. This is, I'm just helping this analysis. It may or may not click or may be acceptable to everyone. Some may say, you know, the karana kala has not changed, the kala has changed, karana kala is gone. If it is gone, then how can the karya survive? I'll ask you that question. Desha kala have been accepted as karana. You cannot have, otherwise I'll ask you to create something without space in anything you can create, but without desha and kala, you cannot create anything that you have to put together. Also, it has to be in some desha and kala. If you take away desha and kala, how can they be there? But a waker sees that yesterday, whatever was there in a particular desha, it is there in that desha. However, the kala has changed. If kala has changed, then you cannot assume it to be the same padartha. This is the analysis which is done for a tarkika in Vedanta Paribhasha also. In the case of vritti, when you are looking at a ghata, that ghata, if you keep on looking at it, there is a ghata vritti, there is a ghata vritti, there is a ghata vritti, so on, there are ghata vrittis. In a sequence of these vrittis, how is the cognition taking place? So there kala is karana, kala is different. Kala being different, the vritti is different. So there is a new jnana born. Ghata, ghata, ghata. It is not the same ghata. Ghata has changed. It is like the lamp which is burning, you see in a still place, you know, still in the sense where there is no wind. So it's not a windy place. In that kind of a place, you see a lamp is continuously there. That the flame of the lamp, you know, the lamp in the sense, the light of the lamp, the flame of the lamp is unflickery. That unflickery flame looks like a, you don't even know whether it is a, these days you get these bulbs in the shape of a flame. So it looks like that bulb. You don't know whether it is really fire or is it an electrical lamp. You don't know. It appears sthira, but it is a changing flame. It is burning oxygen every moment. It is burning oil every moment. Burning fuel every moment. So that fuel has different, the burning is different, the fire is different, but appears to be same. Similarly, here the kala changing, it may appear to be the same thing in a same place, but it is not. So that is the mukhya siddhanta. And therefore, dvitiya jagarana paryantam ajnata satta bhavad jagrati padartaha na anuvartante. They are not continuously existent. This is siddhanta. Those who do not understand this. Mukhya siddhanta ajnanam, ajnaninam. Those who do not understand this mukhya siddhanta, teshameva jagrat padartanam stiratta buddhi bhavati. So he is saying that your question is not valid. Many have this question, but then their question is invalid. It can be answered in many ways. So you have to pick. If you are a drishti srishti vadin, if this appeals to you, then you have to use any answer that convinces you. Mukhya siddhanta is, it is not the same padartha. Why so? You use any reason that is going to help you. I have given you some. You can use any. And here, the explanation is that there is no continuity. Nanu jagarat swapnam anubhuya punar jagarane sati prathama jagare ye artha anubhutaha te eva swapna vyavahita, swapna vyavahita dvitiya jagare. Swapna vyavahita dvitiya jagare is in the second waking state. What is that second? First being before you had swapna anubhava. So swapna is doing segmentation. Swapna is dividing the first waking state and the second waking state. So swapna vyavahita dvitiya jagare api anubhuyante teva arthaha. This is the thinking. Nanu, it is an objection by a srishti drishti vadin, trisatta vadin, natu tatha prathama swapna drishta padartha dvitiya swapne drishyante. But in swapna, second swapna, you do not have continuity of the first swapna padarthas. Tasmat swapna padartha pekshaya jagrat padartha vilakshana eva iti chet na tanna. That is not a valid argument that swapna padarthas, when you compare with jagrat padarthas, then jagrat padarthas are having a particular satta. They are different from the swapna. Therefore, swapnot mithya you cannot say. Jagrat padartha, swapna padartha apekshaya vilakshana. Meaning, mithya padartha apekshaya vilakshana. So, satya. Jagrat padartha satya, swapna padartha mithya. If this is the argument, then mukhya siddhanta ajnana moolakatvad asyaha shankaya. Why so? Because you, the questioner, do not know the mukhya siddhanta vivarana paksha. You are not a drishti srishti vadin. You are not a eka jiva vadin. You have taken to the explanations without understanding the apavada which is going to come up. You are holding on to the adhyaropa of the various avasthas. Tatahi advaita shastrasya mukhya siddhanta ajnanam evam drishtir bhavati. What do they think? Samsara pravaha ayam anadihi. Anadi samsara vartate. This is what Siddhanti also says. But what is it? It is for the masses. Tatra jivasya jagrat swapna shushupti avastha bhavanti. This swapna pravaha, samsara pravaha is continuous. One keeps on being born again and again and again. Since time beginless, one has been continuing. That jiva, tatra jivasya jagrat swapna shushupti avastha bhavanti. There are three states that this jiva goes through in each and every janma. Jagrat kale swapna shushupti nashyataha, swapna kale jagrat shushupti nashyataha, tathaiva shushupto jagrat swapne nashyataha. These three are unique states where the other two do not exist. Parantu yada swapna shushupti bhavataha tada jagrati anubhuta dharapatya dhanapashu gruhakshetra ramadayah aminashyantaha anuvartanta eva. However, when the swapna and shushupti are there, the jagrat padarthas, which are whether your spouse or dhana, pashu, griha, kshetra, these are all अविनिश्यंतः अनुवर्तन्त दे कंटिन्यू. दिस इज थिंकिंग अदरवाइज यू टेल समवन यू गो टू स्लीप योर स्पाउस योर हाउस योर धना योर कैटल नन ऑफ दीज विल बी देयर. हु विल गो टू स्लीप? नोबडी विल गो टू स्लीप. Everyone assumes without thinking that the world is going to continue the way it is. Everything that I earned today, tonight, till tonight, all that is going to continue the next morning when I wake up. I will continue. Everything else will continue as it is. This is the trust you put in the system that you have been living in, and then you happily sleep. Tesham jnanam eva vinashyati. I just don't know that they exist, but they do exist. पुनर्जागरणं यदा भवति तदा प्रथम जागृति स्थित पदार्थानामेव ज्ञानं भवति इति. एंड व्हेन आई वेक अप आई अगेन स्टार्ट कॉग्नाइजिंग दी सेम पदार्थाः. इयं च मुख्य सिद्धांत अज्ञानां दृष्टिः. दे डू नॉट नो दी मुख्य सिद्धांत. जागृत पदार्थ सर्वेपि तद्विषयक ज्ञानेन सह उत्पद्यन्ते ज्ञानेन सह एव विनश्यन्ति च. दिस इज दी मुख्य सिद्धांत. The jagrat padarthas, all of them, and the jnana, tadvishayaka jnana, jagrat padartha vishayaka jnana also, are simultaneously born, manifest, however you want to say it, jnanena sahayava vinashyanti cha. With jnana itself, they have vinasha. Now some people may think that, oh, this is kshanika vijnana vada. No, sir, drishti srishti vada is not kshanika vijnana vada. Those who think that drishti srishti vada is kshanika vijnana vada, just because jnanena sahaiva vinashyanti cha, they neither understand kshanika vijnana nor do they understand drishti srishti vada. This is a problem. Without understanding either paksha, you equated. What basis do you have? That person's opinion should be set aside, whoever that is, whether it is. So, whether it is shukadapi, shukadapi. Otherwise, said as baladapi, shukadapi. So, jnana which is valid should be taken even from a parrot or or shukamuni, or from a child or shukamuni. Both the versions exist. Shuka is shukamuni also. Vyasaputra shuka. Or shuka is a parrot also. Whether a parrot says a tattva, you analyze the tattva on the merits, not on who said it. So if tattva is mentioned by a parrot or by Shukamuni or a child or a Shukamuni, it is valid. Because it is tattva, it is reality. Otherwise it is vithand. Because you say it is wrong, because a child said it, because a parrot said it is wrong, is not a sadhu analysis. Sadhu analysis is their merit in the argument. And if it is illogical, if it is not valid, it is not tattva, it is not reality spoken, whether it is by shuka or shuka, bala or shuka, both have to be set aside. Just because Shukamuni said it, it's a statement, of course, we don't know of anything that invalid said by shuka, it is a proverbial use. So when you compare this kshanika vijnana vada, even the best of the Swamiji says, I don't want to name anyone, but if someone has said that no, drishti srishti vada is same as kshanika vijnana vada, I would say that Swamiji does not know any better. Whoever that is. If someone who is a dvaitin, not an advaitin at all, that person also says he does not know any siddhanta, does not know Buddhism also, does not know kshanika vijnana vada also. Kshanika cannot be set aside. Kshanika, are we saying the Vijnana is kshanika without anything else being there? We have the main difference in all vadas versus Advaita Siddhanta is the jnana never goes away. The chidrupa jnana never goes away. The vritti rupa jnana is kshanika. So the main difference between others, the kshanika vijnana vada, and us is what? Their jnana is kshanika, our vritti rupa jnana is also kshanika. But they do not have anything after that. Jnana goes away, vijnana goes away. We have the cognizer, sakshi, chaitanya continuing. That is the Mukhya Siddhanta. Mukhya Siddhanta, as revealed by the Shruti, cannot be Kshanika Vijnana Vada. So the person is doing a lot of harm if one says that this is same as Kshanika Vijnana Vada. So Siddhanta tu evam. Just if we look at this one para. Sarve padartha chaitanya vivarta ajnanasya parinamascha. So we know this. Ajnana parinama, avidya parinama is a padartha with the Brahma Chaitanya being the Vivarta Karana. Tasmat Shukti Rajatavat Yadayav Padartha Pratiyate Tada Adhishthana Chaitanya Shrita Vidyayaha Dvidha Parinamo Jayate Avidyayaha Tamogunaushasya Ghatadi Vishay Rupaha Parinamaha Bhavati. So Avidya is Tamogunsha. Avidya is Maya, which is Trigunatmika. So there is a Tamoguna, which is the Parinami Karana for Vishayas. So it morphs itself into the Vishaya. Avidyayaha Sattvagunaushasya. Sattvaguna is there in the Avidya. That Avidya Sattvagunaushasya Jnana Rupa Parinamo Bhavati. The Sattvaguna morphs itself into Jnana. Vritti Rupa Jnana. Yadyapi Chaitanyasya. So Ghata Vishaya is the Avidya Tamoguna Parinama. And Ghata Jnana is the Avidya Sattvaguna Parinama. Yadyapi chaitanyasya eva jnanamiti vyapadeshat sattvaguna parinamasya jnanattoktir nasangachyate tathapi sarvam vyapaka chaitanyam jnanam kintu sabhasa vrtyaruna chaitanyam eva jnanamityuchyate. Although the lakshana vakya is satyam jnanam anantam, their jnanam, if you look at that bhashya, I encourage everyone to study the taittiriya bhashya on jnanam. It is, the bhashya is twice. Twice in the sense jnanam is analyzed, then others are analyzed, and then Bhagavan Bhashyakara comes back and analyzes jnanam. That jnana is chidrupa jnana, where the jnana is interpreted in the initial analysis as dhatu rupa, jnya dhatu, nyaptihi jnanam. Nyapti is bhava sadhana, bhava, bhave vitpatti. But then Shuddha Dhatvartha is mentioned there. But that Jnana, Jnanam, Lyudartha is Bhave Vitpatti, Lyut Pratya becomes Ana, Yuranakau, then Jnanam, Napumsakam. This Jnanam means Jnadhatu, Nyaptihi, with Tin Pratya, Bhave Vitpatti, Jnanam is explained as Nyaptihi. That Nyaptihi, meaning Jnadhatu Artha, is what? To know. In English, we'll say to know. When as soon as you say to know, what is this Jnadhatu? Jnadhatu is Sakarmaka Dhatu. So Sakarmaka Dhatu has karma apeksha, vyakrana karma apeksha. So it expects an object. One may or may not supply, but it is expecting. If I say I know, what do I know? You are going to ask me, what do you know? I may not say what I know. But then the statement is meaningless. As soon as someone says, I know, there is an apeksha. So, jnadhatu, to know what is the apeksha. Therefore, Purva Pakshi says this, jnā has apeksha of dhatu. Even if you say it is shuddha dhatu artha, brahma jnanam. Not brahma jnanam, brahma is satyam jnanam anantam. So, satyam jnanam anantam brahma, jnanam brahma, Satyam Brahma, Jnanam Brahma, Anantam Brahma. As soon as you say Jnanam Brahma, being in Samanari Karanam, Brahma is Jnanam, where it is Shuddha Dhatu Artha and you expect the object there. So something Dvitiya is there. Dependency on Dvitiya is there. So how do you say Advitiya Brahma? It is no longer Advitiya. Jnana Brahma is no longer Advitiya Brahma. This is the Pura Paksha there. And Bhagavan Bhashyakara does not say it in so many words that your objection is valid. But he gives an answer which shows that the objection is valid. He says that is why Jnana Artha is not Nyapti also. It is not Shuddha Dhatrupa also. It is Chinmatra. Chaitanya Chit is the real meaning of Jnana. So when you use Jnana other than the Lakshana Vakya, there the Jnana is having the apeksha of karma, सकर्मक धातु. Therefore, when you say you know something, that jnana is vritti rupa jnana. Not chidrupa jnana, vritti rupa jnana. So that is dealt with here. Yadyapi chaitanya seva jnana miti vyapadeshat. Since chaitanya itself is called a jnana, why? Satyam jnanam anantam brahma. That chaitanya is chidrupa jnana. Brahma is chidrupa jnana. Therefore, sattva guna parinamasya jnanatva uktir nasangachyate. But how do you say that it is sattva guna parinama? It is not. Although it isn't valid, still tathapi sarvam vyapaka chaitanyam na jnanam. This vyapaka chaitanya is not jnana, kintu sabhasa vrityaruna chaitanyam eva jnanam ityuchyate. What kind of chaitanya? That vritti rupa jnana is chaitanya, is jnana here. It is not the chaitanya that you talk about in the ज्ञान शब्द लक्षण वाक्य. तस्मात् चैतन्य ज्ञान व्यवहार से संपादिका वृत्तिरेव इति चैतन्यस्य ज्ञानत्वापादको उपाधि भूत वृत्तौ अपि ज्ञान शब्द प्रयुज्यते. सो वृत्ति रूप ज्ञान इज कॉल्ड एज वृत्ति रूप ज्ञान इज द मीनिंग ऑफ ज्ञान शब्द हियर. घट ज्ञानम जातम पट ज्ञानम नष्टम इति लोके व्यवहारो दृश्यते. सो घट ज्ञान इज बॉर्न पट ज्ञान वेंट अवे. व्हेन यू से दैट दैट टाइम इट इज नॉट चिद रूप ज्ञान ऑब्वियसली. चैतन्य इज कंटिन्यूइंग. Therefore, jnana shabda here is vritti rupa jnana. Tatra vrittyaruna chaitanyasya swataha utpatti nasha sambhavyapi upadhi bhuta vrittehe tatsambhava jnane utpatti nasha vyavaharo bhavati. So this nasha of jnana, what is this nasha of jnana? We want to say that jagrat padartha jnana goes away and it comes back again. But the jagrat padarthas are different in the dvitiya jagrana. So that is the Siddhanta for which the Jnana itself is analyzed first. We'll continue in the next part. Sukhan Nityam Suprakasham Vyapakan Namarupa Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhir Param Sarvedanta Vidyam Pratyak Paramaha Tadevanamattu Nishchitamati Hi Tat Sat. Namaste.
Namaste.